Hi students, how are you? I hope you all are fine at your home. This is your English teacher KV Lakshmi, KGBV, Tondangi, East Godavari district. Today I want to teach you a reading of first unit. Before going to our class, I want to tell you a small story related to our lesson. Okay children, all of you ready for the story? Okay.
Story name is Lazy Son. A rich money lender lived in a town with his wife and son. His son name was Sumit. He was very lazy. The money lender was very hard working. He used to go to Shiva temple every morning before sunrise. After that he used to around of his farm stable where he all business was spread. The money lender was very upset with his son's lazy attitude. The father trying to wake up his son. Son replied, "Not now, doubt. Let me sleep for a while." Money lender got very upset and went to farms alone. After some days, he got very sick and he died soon. Even after the death of his father, Sumit did not take any interest in his father's business. Due to that, they were having massive loss in the business. Seeing this, Sumit's mother said to him, "Son, we are facing a great loss in the business. So, what can I do in this? I don't have any knowledge of the business," the son replied. "Even I have never gone to the farms with dad." The mother told his son, "Do one thing. Your grandfather lives in the next village. He has a great knowledge of this business. You go and meet him. He must be having a solution for this problem." "All right, mom, I will go tomorrow only." Next morning, Sumit went to his grandfather, greeted grandpa. Grandpa told, "God bless you, son. Tell me, how are you?" Sumit said, "After dad's death, we are facing a great loss in business. Mom told me that I should come to you for your exercise. Now only you can help us in this." Grandpa told, "Your mom is absolutely right. I have a solution for your problem." "Tell me, Grandpa, tell me quickly." Grandpa told, "You just have to do one thing like your father. You have to go to Shiva temple every morning before sunrise. And after that, you have to look after all your business and you have to do this every day." "All right, I will do the same. What you told me." From next morning, Sumit started waking up before sunrise. He first went to Shiva temple and after that he goes to look after all his business. Every morning he goes to farms, then ration shop, after that to his stable. It went on for few days. Seeing him coming to work every day, the labor were discussing with each other. "Did you see the boss is coming every day to work now?" "Yes, it seems that we have to stop all the scams now." "You are right, otherwise we will be trapped." Gradually all the laborers saw that Sumit was taking rounds of the shop and the farms, and in the fear of to be trapped, they stopped all the scams. After the stopping of camps, they increased their business and Sumit and his mom gradually become rich again. Sumit said, "Oh mom, look, due to grandpa advice, we again become rich." Mother said, "You are right, son. You should go to your grandpa and thank him." Sumit did the same what his mother told and he went to his grandfather's house. "Grandpa, thank you so much. You have done a miracle. Just because of you, our business has flourished again, grandfather." "My son, I have not done anything. You only have done all the hard work." "What, me? But how?" "Grandfather, this all was happening due to your laziness. Just because of your lazy attitude, you are not focusing on your business and the labor were taking advantage of that and done all the scams. But now you are going to work every day. So they stopped all the scams in fear to be caught and your business has flourished again. By listening to his grandfather, he realized his mistake. He left his laziness and started working very hard on his business and lived happily. Moral of the story. We must complete our work on time by sacrificing our laziness.
Okay, students, how is the story? I hope you all are enjoyed the story. Did you like it? I think all of you liked the story. Okay, don't be lazy, be active. Okay, now we can go to our lesson. First of all, the theme of our lesson. What is the theme? Personality development. What is the children? Personality development. Personality development. So, what is personality? First of all, we learn what is personality. Personality is nothing but qualities. Every person have certain qualities. Qualities are also called characteristics or features. And someone have good qualities or may have bad qualities. So how we measure qualities? If we look at any cine actors, for example, I'm telling, if we see any cine actors, we measure their qualities with their external qualities only. What we see? We see only their acting, physique, their dancing, etc. From them, we are telling they have great personalities. In the same way, if we see any politicians, how we measure them? We measure them their surviving, how they rule. So, for them, we are seeing their internal qualities. So, like that, we can measure the person's personalities. Okay, children? Okay, in the first unit, we learn ARD. The lesson name is Attitude is Altitude. What is the lesson name? Attitude is Altitude. Attitude is Altitude. Okay, this is our lesson name. So, in this heading, we learn some words. What is attitude and what is altitude? Attitude means way of thinking. Way of thinking. And altitude means height. So, I'm telling you about the attitude. What is attitude? Way of thinking. For way of thinking, I tell you a small story. What is done in class? Okay, one teacher asked the students, what is there in the glass? One student told of empty. The glass is of empty. Another student told glass is of full. So, from this picture, both the answers are correct. But, of empty. One student told of empty. Then the child seeing what nothing is there. So the child is thinking negatively. At the same time, the another student told the glass is half full. So the child seeing here what they have. So the child is thinking positively. Based on this, we are going to our lesson. Attitude is attitude. Before going to attitude is attitude, what is there in our face sheet? In our face sheet, there are three persons. Who are they? The first person is Sudhachandran, and the second person is Stephen Hawking, and the third person is Helen Keller. So these members are facing so many physical problems in their lives, but they are very successful in their lives. What they faced in their lives, what they faced problems. Sudhachandran. She met with a road accident. She lost her leg, but she is a famous dancer. She acted in so many films. Now she is acted in TV serials also. Next, Stephen Hawking. He was a famous physicist and scientist. He was fully paralyzed, but his brain is working. He worked on a black holes. Okay. The next third person is Helen Keller. She is a famous writer from America, but she is blind and dumb from childhood. So from these face sheet, we have two questions in our textbook. What are they? The first question is, what qualities have made these persons great? These three persons are facing disability, but they are very famous with their hard work. So they all have positive qualities. Okay, children? The second question is, what qualities do you think a person requires to become successful? Oh, this is a very big question. If we want to be successful, first of all, we should have discipline. We should have hard work. We should have discipline. And we should have focus. And we should have motivation, etc. So, like that, we have to be successful in our life. Now, we are going to our lesson. Attitude is attitude. In this lesson, the main character is Nick Vujicic. He is a famous person. Though he has no arms and legs, he is the best and good motivational speaker in the world. From this lesson, we will also learn a lesson, and we should be motivated by this lesson. So, first of all, if you have textbooks, open your textbooks, page number 3. Okay, children? Now, I read the passage. You look at in your textbook. From this A reading, we have questions like this. First of all, I want to tell you how would we face the questions from this lesson. From each para, we have so many words. And from the words, we are writing in exams synonyms. So, children, all of you listen carefully and write the meanings also. And every word should have meaning. So, like that, we have synonyms in paper 2. So, first of all, I want to tell you the first passage. Imagine having no arms to stretch in the morning. Stretch. What is the first word? Stretch. Stretch means extend. Extend. Stretch means extend. Extend means to like this. Our hands like this. At the time of morning, wake up, we are doing our hands like this. But imagine having no arms. If we have no arms, how extend your hands. So imagine. Imagine means thinking without hands. To help you scratch that itch. If you feel any itch, what would you have? We should have hands for doing rub the itch. So the meaning of the word itch. Itch means rub. Itch means rub. To allow you to wrap your arms around your loved ones. If you meet any loved ones after a long time, we should take our hands around them like this. Okay. Now imagine having no legs to kick pebbles down the street, to walk or run, to bicycle or skateboard, or get you from point A to point B. Then imagine both at once. So first of all, we imagine if you have no hands. But now we are imagining if you have no legs. How would you kick the pebbles down, and how to walk, and how to run, and how to bicycle, and how to skateboard? And now imagine you both have no at once. That means you have no and legs. Just imagine, which is what Nick Vujicic has faced his whole life. Have you heard something like this before? Okay. Now, who has no arms and legs? That person is Nick Vujicic. If we are imagining if no legs and arms, that is very difficult to us. But Nick Vujicic is now also facing the problem without arms and legs. So from that person we are learning here. Okay. Nick Vujicic was born with no arms and legs, but he doesn't let the details stop him. The brave 26-year-old, who is mainly a torso, plays football and golf, swims and surfs, despite having no legs. Limbs means limbs, arms, legs. He has no arms and legs, but he can play football. How do we play football? We are playing football with our two legs, but he has no legs, but he can play football. How? You can imagine. And golf, he can play golf also. Swim and swimming. At the time of swimming, we can use our hands and legs, but he has no arms and legs, but he can swim and surf. He can surf also, despite having no limbs. Children, imagine once. Nick has a small foot on his left hip. Children, if you have a textbook, all of you look at the textbook, which is swimming Nick Vujicic. Here he has a small foot on his left hip, where he has his left hip. Nick has a small foot on his left hip, which helps him balance and enables him to kick. He uses his one foot to type, write with a pen, and pick things up between his toes. So in spite of he has no arms and legs, but he got a small foot on his left hip. With the help of the left hip, he uses typing and writing with the help of left hip. Okay. I call it my chicken drumstick. Joker Nick, who was born in Melbourne, Australia, but now lives in Los Angeles. I had been lost without. Water sports are not Nick's only thing. He also plays golf with a club tucked under his chin. and is a huge fan of the English Premier League. Okay, children, how he tucked the golf stick? Now I am showing here. Look at here. Okay, this like he plays golf. His favorite game also. His parents, his age come to go to school. Now his parents decided not to send him a special school. Why he sent a special school? Because he is a torso. He has no arms and legs. But the parents decided not to send him a special school. A decision he said was very hard for him, but which may have been the best decision they could have made for him. But in future, he realized that is the best decision, because if he joined in a special school, he can't learn anything. Because of the normal school, he learned so many things from them and in that school. Next, when Nick was born, his father was so shocked. Here you can look at Nick's father. Look at on the board. That he left the hospital room to vomit. If any father look at the first time born children, they feel very happy. But why Nick's father went to vomit? Because he is torso. His distraught mother could not bring herself to hold him until he was 4 months. 4 months after giving the birth, the mother take her baby. But Nick's mother could not hold her child up to 4 months. Okay, children. Now, next base. So, which disability he faced? His disability came without any medical explanation. A rare occurrence called phocomelia. What is his disability? His disability name is phocomelia. Phocomelia. This is Nick's disability. And Nick and his parents spent many years asking why this cruel trick would happen to them. That means they feel very much about the child. Why this type of child give the God to me? What we done mistake? Like that they are discussing. My mother means whose mother? Nick's mother. Not your mother and my mother. Nick's mother. My mother was a nurse and she did everything right during pregnancy. But she still blamed herself, he said. Okay, in pregnancy time, all ladies are taking good precautions for giving health baby. But the God gave them like this type of child. But he is a famous motivational speaker in nowadays. Okay, it was so hard for them. But right from the start, they did their best to make me independent. So, some parents are, if the child is any problem, they only take care the child. But from the starting, what he can do himself, they can leave the baby, that means Nick, and they gave him independence in doing his works. My dad means Nick's father. Nick's father. Not your father and my father. My father means Nick's father. Nick's, my dad put me in the water at 18 months and gave the courage to learn how to swim in 18 months. 18 months after 1 year. 18 months means. In 18 months. In which month the father put him into water? In 18th month. 18th month. this is the question in this line. In which man Nick's father put him into water? Why his father put him into water? Because learning swim. Okay. I also got really into football and skateboard. I totally love the English Premier League. So he is like playing football. That's why he learned very well football also. Without legs, how he play football? Now I show you here how he play football. Okay? How he play football? He has a foot on his left hip. With the left hip, he can play football. Okay? Nick's father was a computer programmer. Yes, do you know? He was a computer programmer. That means working with computer. His father, Nick's father. An accountant, and he taught his little son how to type with his toe at just 6 years old. And you can see here how he typed with his toe. Okay? How he typed with his toe. Okay, na? At just 6 years old. At 6 years old. At the time of 6 years old, he typed with his toe. He typed the computer typing with the help of his toes. His mom invented a special plastic device. That meant he could hold a pen and pencil. His mom, that means Nick's mom. Okay, his mom invented a plastic device for holding pen and pencil to write. Okay. Despite the risk of being bullied, his parents insisted on his attending mainstream school. If he faced any problem in normal school, but the parents sent him to normal school only. It was the best decision they could have made for him. Adds Nick, who later achieved a degree in financial planning and real estate. Now, the next job is financial planning and real estate. Job, financial planning and real estate. It was very hard, but it gave me independence. He told his job is very hard, but he continuously doing hard work for his future, and he got the job. Nick, who was teased and bullied, had an electric wheelchair for mobility and a team of carers to help him. For moving, how he can move without arms and legs? How he can move? He can move with the help of electrical wheelchair. For example, I am saying Oopri movie. All of you watch Oopri movie. Nagarjuna sitting like a wheelchair. Like that, Nick also used wheelchair for moving this side to that side. Okay? Once you can watch that movie also. I was deeply depressed. Who is I here? Nick. Who is I? Nick. Nick was deeply depressed when I was 8 years old. In how many years? 8 years old. Why? In 8 years old. In the age of 6, he know how to type with his toe. At the age of 8, he fully depressed. Why he depressed? I went to my mom crying and told her I wanted to kill myself. Then the mother shocked. He told, I want to kill myself. Then how do we feel? If any child came to her mother, said, I want to kill myself. The mother feel very shockingly. So like that he told his mother. His mother was very shocked. Then they have some discussion. In the discussion, at the time, what they discussed in our conversation writing. Okay, what they discussed. Nick and his mother. Why he wanted to suicide and how mother stopped him. Okay, children. I felt cold and bitter. Cold and bitter. How we feel in winter season? We feel very cold. At that time, what we do? We can take our blanket and cover our body. But Nick has no arms and legs. Then how he could cover his body? Then he feels so much about his hands and legs. And I hated God for doing this to me and was terrified of what would happen when my parents were not there to look after me. Then he remembered his parents. If the parents are not there, how he can grow? Then at that time, in one side, he hated God, but in other side, he thanked God because giving him the good parents like these parents. Okay. I could brush my own teeth with a wall-mounted brush and wash my own hair with palm action soap. How he could brush and how he can ready to in his daily life, I can show here and see sometime. Okay, children? I could brush my own teeth with a wall-mounted brush and wash my own hair with pump action soap. But there was so much that was impossible for me. And sometimes there was so much impossible for him that at the time his father helped him so much. Okay. What is the opposite word impossible, children? Impossible. Impossible. Opposite name is possible. Here we can say these are prefix. At the time of prefixes in the opposite words, we can cut the prefix word and we can write opposite word. That is the opposite word of impossible, possible, like this. Okay. We have antonym also in our second paper. At age 10, Nick tried to drown himself in the bathtub. Luckily, the attempt was unsuccessful. Why he drowned himself in bathtub? Because he wanted to suicide, but he hated his life. That's why he wanted to drown in bathtub. But the attempt is luckily unsuccessful. I felt there was no purpose. When you lack purpose and strength, it is hard to hold on, he said. But with the help of his religion, friends and family, Nick managed to pull through to become an international symbol of triumph over adversity. Yes, these type of persons have some are having negative qualities, but luckily Nick has positive qualities. With the positive qualities, the family members and relatives and religions helped him very much in his life growth, and luckily he became a famous in the world. When I was 13, and in this textbook I am telling I, and who is I here? Nick. In this lesson, who is I here? Nick. All of you remember, I, him, he, these all are Nick only. Okay, children. When I was 13 years, I read a newspaper article about a disabled man who had managed to achieve great things and helped others. Nick said. Children, I am showing you the newspaper article here. All of you look at the newspaper article. From this newspaper article, Nick changed his behavior from killing to himself. From the newspaper clipping, he is realized why God had made us like this. to give hope to others. So he decided the God is giving birth me to give hope to others. Like that he grow and like a motivational speaker. It was so inspirational to me that I decided to use my life to encourage other people and give them the courage that the article had given me. From that article, he learned that to give hope to others. That's why he can grow and he changed like a motivational speaker. From his motivations, so many members have changed their behavior. Okay, so here we can see his motivational classes. I decided to be thankful for what I do have, not get angry about what I don't have. Okay, children. In this, he said he thankful for God what he have, and not get angry about what I don't. Okay, children. You also like that. Don't do any angry with your parents what he don't have. So what you have, live happily with that only. Okay. I looked at myself in the mirror and said, I means Nick. Nick looking himself in mirror. You know what the world is right, that I have no arms and legs, but they will never take away the beauty of my eyes. He is recognized eyes beauty, and he always talking with his eyes also. But I wanted to concentrate on something good that I had. What I can do good, that only I can do from this, from today's. Like that, Nick decided and continued his life with happily. The challenges in our lives are there to strengthen our convictions. They are not there to run us over, said Nick. Challenges are coming to our lives very fast and they go very slowly. But we can face our challenges with courage. Okay, in 1990, Nick won the Australian Young Citizen of the Year Award for his bravery and perseverance. Okay, he got an award from Australian Young Citizen also in 1990. And once I was in a car. It's very funny thing, children. Listen carefully. And once I was in a car, a girl at traffic lights. Yes, do you know traffic lights? These are traffic lights. Traffic lights like this. Traffic lights. Green, red, yellow. Red, yellow, green. These are traffic lights. And I can show you a picture. Look at here, the picture of traffic lights. At traffic lights was looking at me interestingly. She could only see my head because he is sitting in the car. So I decided to do a 360 degree spin in the car seat to freak her out. Her face was like, wow, what is going on? She sped off really quickly. That means he's sitting in the car like this. The girl is seeing from this side. His face is like this and like this. Suddenly, he moved like this. Then the girl quickly feared and suddenly speed off her car. Okay, children? Why? Because he turned like this. He has no arms and legs. That's why in this seat, he turned in 360 degrees. 360 degrees means, you know, like this. Okay. Here, he is like this. At the time of seeing the girl, he is doing like this. Nick began traveling the world, and in 2008, he went to Hawaii and met surfing master Bethany Hamilton. And one of his passions, surfing is passion. So here we can see his surfing. And here we can see his surfing teacher. Her name is Bethany Hamilton. Her name is Bethany Hamilton. Bethany Hamilton. And here we can see her picture. Who had her arms beaten off by a shark when she was 12? Why he chose that type of teacher? Because he has no arms and legs. That's why he selected this type of teacher. How she can teach like that? He can imagine and he can choose this type of teacher for learning surfing. Then at the time, conversation between Bethany Hamilton and Nick, it is also coming to over in a creative expressions conversation between Nick and his teacher Bethany Hamilton. Okay, she was amazing. Who is she? She, Bethany Hamilton, said Nick. She taught me how to surf and I was terrified at first. But once I got up there, it felt absolutely fantastic and I caught some waves pretty well. Nick quickly learned how to do the 360 degree spin on his board, a feat that got him on the cover of Surfer magazine within 48 hours. No one has ever done that in the history of surfing, he said. But I have a very low center of gravity, so I have got pretty good balance. Because of gravity power, he can balance his body very well. That's why he can learn fastly the surfing. The surfing teacher also surprised the fastly learning of the surfing by Nick Wizzis. Okay, children. He has visited different countries. Who is he? Nick. Nick has visited different countries all over the world. The football fan is now a motivational speaker and has traveled to over 24 countries speaking to groups of up to 110,000 people. Up to then he is a football player. But that time he changed like a motivational speaker. For them, he overly traveled 24 countries and he nearly met 110,000 people by his speech. And he can change so many people who have no hopes on their lives. He can change their lives. He moved to Los Angeles in 2007 and planned to continue to travel the world. In 2009, he visited South America and the Middle East. In 2008, Canon Mehra. Who is she? A beautiful young girl. We can see the picture of Kanai Mara here. Okay, look at here. Whose mother was a Mexican? Her mother is a Mexican. Whose father was a Japan? Her father was Japan. Attended to a meeting where Nick was the guest speaker in Texas. Kanan was attracted to Nick's message. Kanan was attracted by Nick's message. On the next page. From that time, they were in touch with each other to share their ideas and giving hope to the needy, and they became close friends. They means Nick and Kanan became close friends by the motivational class. Okay. Finally, they fell in love and their engagement happened in August 2009. Finally, they fell into love and they got engaged in 2009. We can see their engagement pictures also here in 2011. Nick put the engagement ring on Canon's finger with his mouse, and we can see the picture also here. And then said the most beautiful words every girl wants to hear coming out from her man's mouth. Baby, I love you. So Nick said to Canon, I love you. Yes, you know very well the meaning of the words. Nick and Canon got married on February 12, 2012. February 12, 2012. They got married, Nick and Canon. And on February 13, 2013, after 1 year, they got a healthy baby. They got a healthy baby by God's blessings. Nick and Canon wrote an inspirational book. They wrote a famous book also. What is the book name? They wrote a famous book, Love Without Limits. This is the book who wrote this book? Nick and his wife Canon. They wrote the book together and it was published in 2014. Okay. Finally Nick said one thing. If I fail, I try again and again and again. If you fail, are you going to try again? Nick asked like this. The human spirit can handle much worse than we realize. It matters how you are going to finish. Are you going to finish strong? Said Nick. If you want to do anything, we can finish it with hard working in any matter. Okay, don't leave any work what we choose in middle. Okay, complete the work. Don't leave it the middle. I tell people to keep on getting up when they fall and to always love themselves, he said. If I can encourage just one person, then my job in this life is done. Nick said, if one person will encourage with his motivation, his job is finished in this world. Okay, children, like this he giving motivations for the people and who has no interested on their lives. Okay, from his life we can learn so many things. We have arms and legs and we have full body and we have whatever we want. So from that we can read well and we can settle in a better position. Okay, now I want to tell you how the questions are coming from this lesson. First of all, I want to tell you about synonyms, how the synonyms came from this unit. And from this unit, from ear reading only we are getting synonyms and antonyms. Okay, children. So as possible as you can read all the words synonyms. Okay, I will tell you one passage sentence how the question paper is given and how we can write the synonyms to the words. Okay, children.
Synonyms from this lesson. Children, all of you look at the textbook first passage like this. From your starting para is the starting passage only coming like this synonyms. Now note down the synonyms which are coming from first passage. Imagine, visualize, help, assist, both together, faced, experienced. Like these words, note down your notebooks. Next, second passage. Students, second passage. Same passage but synonyms are changed. Clearly observe the words and note down your notebooks I will tell the answers. First word, stretch, extend, scratch, rub, allow, permit, whole, entire. Now, antonyms. Same passage, we can do antonyms also from this passage. The antonyms are like this. Okay, now note down the antonyms from this passage. Which words are antonyms from this passage? The first word is stretch, and the second word is allow. Third word is love, loved. Fourth word is whole. So, you can match the opposite words from this passage. Okay, children, read and write carefully. Okay.